second expansion here for the taking. He's been forcing the issue with this expansion too much. And looks like we have a couple of Hellions here able to make it through and good to take out all those probes, just enough to one shot all the probes. However, these Hellions are going to take out so many. The probes, do not stack the probes on top of each other. Oh, the pain! Six kills on this Hellion. I bet the others had around 8 or 5. So excellent worker harass here from our Terran player to keep himself in the game and to stay in the lead. Slightly in the lead though. In the worker count. However, Bishop did have an excess amount of workers here, so he can transfer as many probes as he wants to the gold. Looks like a Bishop here is moving out with his army, going to harass this expansion. It's like SoulMiracle is just about to grab his gold. However, this planetary fortress is not going to complete and is going to be unupgraded. We finally have medevacs here for SoulMiracle. However, we have three upgrades for our Protoss player. Guardian Shields going up. These are going to help absorb as much damage as possible. However, I am not seeing any force fields though. I don't think force fields would be very effective right now. However, the Zealots are trying to kill as many units as they can. However, we have a couple of hallucinating immortals also. However, the Protoss army looks like they could be at a disadvantage right now. So he does decide to pull back. Very, very, very intense battle right there. However, the Terran army did come up out of that. And it's like the tanks are going to siege up, the stalkers are going to blink. They're going to do blink micro to avoid as much damage as possible. However, there are no more medivacs here, and this army is indeed very, very hurt. And once again, SoulMiracle trying to retake this expansion, desperately trying to get as many resources as possible. Looking at the minerals per minute, our Terran player is definitely behind. Our Protoss player has saturated second, third, and fourth, and is now warping in 4 more gateways for more army production. So it looks like Bishop is sticking strictly to gateway units here, not going for the traditional. I guess you can call it traditional because every Protoss player loves their Colossus. But Bishop is just showing that you can beat anyone with just the core units of the Protoss army, which are the Zealots and Stalkers. Looks like we're going to see some building harass here with these Blink Stalkers going to blink up on the high ground. Very nice Blink Micro right there. Bishop can take out as many production facilities, and no, he just takes out an add-on and loses a Stalker. Alright, in terms of resources lost, SoulMiracle is at a slight advantage. However, in terms of map control, Bishop is definitely in the lead. He has the Terran player contained, cannot leave his base, and this planetary fortress is about to die, it's about to fall. We have so many charge slots here! And will he pull back and attack? Looks like Bishop does decide to pull back, trying to force the Terran player to use Stim. So excellent use. And we have the Blink Stalkers here trying to take out all the production facilities. And looks like SoulMiracle, a little bit of a BM, no GG, he leaves the game. So there you go. There's map control, there's harass, and there's the attacking of the expansions. And this little army is not enough to defend both at the same time. So SoulMiracle taps. Excellent game here for both players. But Bishop did come out on top. He was ahead in the economy. He had 5 bases going. And yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed that game. That was very intense for me. This has been your friendly neighborhood Dr. Jimmy signing off. Bye-bye.